And he's here today to talk to you a little bit, and he's going to share some wonderful fiddle playing with us. Would you please give a very, very warm welcome to David Juritz.
A Bach prelude in E major. Can I just say it's a huge treat for me to have the opportunity of actually playing indoors for once. I spent the last 4.5 months since I left my house in West London on the 9th of June playing on street corners, trying to earn enough money to pay for my air tickets and my travel expenses to get right around the world. I believe New York is sort of quite fittingly city number 50. But I had this rather harebrained scheme about a year ago when I was looking at the sort of musical project I'd wanted to do, which is to explore the unaccompanied music for violin by J.S. Bach. So the idea came to me in about 2 minutes, really. I thought what I would do is leave the house with a fiddle, backpack, completely empty wallet, and busk my way around the world. Had I given about 5 minutes, I probably wouldn't be here now. But what it did do was give me the opportunity to raise funds and awareness of a cause which I've found very inspiring as a musician for a long time. And that is the idea of social music programs for young people. Our first project is at a school for AIDS orphans. It caters for children of the poorest section of the community in Kampala, Uganda, a high percentage of AIDS orphans, some refugees from under the regional wars. And the project starts, we've now renovated a building for them and bought instruments, and the music lessons are actually starting this week, which I'm very pleased to say. What I said to the Brooklyn Symphony Orchestra, Musequality, the idea of it is actually not to produce another generation of professional musicians. I'm not sure that's what the developing world needs, to be honest. What it does need, if it's to have a future, it needs to have people that have got the self-discipline, the self-belief, the skills that can enable them to go on to achieve the things which that become the teachers, the doctors, the scientists, the business leaders, whatever, that they need for a stable future. And I always think when I visit a group like this, that this is actually the perfect example of what we'd like to try and recreate in the developing world. I believe there's a reception afterwards. I'll be back there. If anyone wants to talk to me, I'd be really delighted to speak to you. There will be, so I've got some CDs on sale as well if you want to help out that way. And we also have a website which you can have a look at. I'm just going to play one other little piece since I'm on a sort of world trip. One of my great passions is the tango music of Astor Piazzolla. This is his tango etude number 3.